Hi, this is Jennifer from Soul Source Tarot, and I'm here to do a reading for Aries. This is for Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus, and this is for the remainder of June. So, I have a message for you, Aries, that has just come to me as I was getting ready to do your reading. This is an intuitive message. My message is to not let somebody take advantage of you because they are money hungry. There will be consequences for that, and you may be suffering. You may suffer the consequences for that. Naive. There's somebody that is being very naive, that is not seeing the true picture. They're not seeing the whole story. You are dealing with an individual that is after your money. They want it all. This is a very selfish individual. And if they're not after your money, that's what they're after. They're after something that you can give them financially. That's all they're after. They only care about themselves. This person is very, 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 very selfish and has, it feels like this person has no heart, is very cold-hearted, and they don't care if they turn your whole family against you. They don't care if you die alone, you know, as long as they get what they want. This is a very selfish individual. I feel as though, you know, you are being blinded by something. It's almost like you've been brainwashed by somebody. So I just want you to take that into account. I think that is going to be very prominent towards the end of this month. My only hope is that you can open your eyes before it's too late. If you think about the judgment card, because that is what I'm thinking now. Judgment is a card of karma. It's a card of, you know, what's judgment day? Judgment day is when you, you know, speak of your sins. You know what I mean? So you make mistakes. When you have judgment day, you go over the bad judgment calls that you've made. Make sure that you are making the right decision, because it feels like there's some sort of decision that is being made and you may not have your eyes fully opened. You know, I think that you're making some sort of life-changing decision based on an illusion. I don't know if you're dealing with a Pisces or a Cancer, somebody that is filling you up. They're hiding something, somebody that is very deceptive. And I'm not saying that it doesn't have to be a Pisces or a Cancer, but it's that kind of moon energy where there's a lot of deception behind you. Somebody is deceiving you to a very great deal. And I think that you really, really, really need to open your eyes, before it's too late. What do we have for Aries? This has something to do with your children. If you have children, if you don't have, and it doesn't have to be a water sign. I don't know who it is. There is somebody that is lying to you and they're doing it for their own good. Okay. They're not doing it because they care about you. All they care about is themselves. And it doesn't matter if they hurt your children or anybody in the process. So now the judgment is also about being accepted, being forgiven, you know, so you just keep that in mind. Will you be forgiven by letting yourself be led down the wrong road by somebody that doesn't have the same morals as you do? What do we have for Aries for the end of June? This person is, all they care about is money or stability in some way. It doesn't have anything really to do with you other than what you can give to them, what they can get from you in this situation. One more card, please. I'm gonna have to, and maybe you need to cut them out of your life. And I'm not saying to cut your children out of your life. You should cut anybody out of your life that is coming in between you and your family. Because your family is blood. Well, family wishes come true. This is about family. I know this is about family. You have somebody that is up to no good. I know that you do. And they're going to come in between you and your family. Kite vacation. Coins, money will be coming to you, and it does have to do with money. I know that it does. Rat. Oh my, I knew this was the case. You are dealing with a rat. This is the person I'm talking about. I know that you have somebody that here that doesn't have good intentions, and this person has really pulled the wool over your eyes. This is a dirty rat. Scumbag. And you know, this person and rats, they usually live in your home. So it's somebody that is right, they probably live with you, or they're very close to you in that, you know, they live with you. Or they did live with you. I think this is somebody that you're with now. It's all about the money. They're coming in between with your family. They're causing problems with your family. Perhaps you need to take a vacation from this rat. But this rat is so cunning and clever that you can't see. It's really sad. Rats are destructive. Sneaky little buggers. What do we have for Aries? This is really sad. It is very, very, very sad. Naive. We have somebody here that is being very naive, letting a rat get the best of them. Ace of Swords reversed. Dishonesty. You're dealing with somebody who's very dishonest, that's not telling you the truth. You're not seeing clearly. You aren't. I know that you're not. Chariot reversed. Unable to master emotions. Lack of discipline. Out of control. Emotions. Your emotions are probably all over the place. There could be a disaster ahead. Somebody's lying. Somebody is being really deceptive. There's a lack of direction here. You're definitely not seeing a situation as it is. World reversed. So this is refusing to explore new avenues, refusing to listen to anyone. Aries, are you refusing to listen to anyone except for this rat? This is unfinished business, not learning a lesson. This is not learning a lesson. Tower reversed. Now what? We have four majors. We got four. No, we got three in the Ace of Swords. So we got three majors. So there's the universe is in control here. Things are out of your control. Or there's a person that is being a real rat as well. But this is a disaster. There's a disaster ahead. I'm sorry, but that is the truth. Even though you may not see it because the Ace of Swords is reversed. There's a lack of clarity. You are being lied to and you're not seeing it. Emotions are all over the place. You're feeling very, very scattered. There's unfinished business with somebody. There's a lack of closure. There's a lack of success. There's a permanent loss here with the Tower reverse. This is extremely painful. Now, there could be an accident with the Tower and the Chariot both reversed, a sudden accident. There's definitely internal disruption within you. You're feeling it. You're feeling this. You're feeling it. You know that something isn't right, but you're not listening to your intuition with that Ace of Swords reverse. You're not. You're not. It's like you're refusing to see that you need to put a stop to something. You're letting this rat lead you down the wrong path. Now, this is a painful change. So there is something very painful that is going on. There may be a separation that is coming. It could happen all of a sudden. This is a dead stop. Five of Cups reversed. Now, this is a prolonged grief. Deep depression. Now, this is needing to accept something. Remember, we talked about judgment was acceptance, and this is lack of acceptance. Now, somebody could be leaving without saying goodbye. I don't know if there's going to be an accident. There could even be a fight. Okay? Now, this is a sad situation. It is, with the Five of Cups reversed. It's extremely sad. We could have somebody here that is extremely shaken, okay? Or shook up. Oh my God, Wheel of Fortune reverse, son of a gun. So this is a huge loss. We have a huge loss. There's a setback. There's something not working out. There's a past mistake coming back to haunt you because you haven't learned from it. You keep repeating the same mistakes. There's naive, not opening your eyes. That's lack of awakening, not seeing the very first card. So you're not seeing something clearly. You're dealing with somebody who is putting out some sort of false information. It is. They're not being truthful. They're not being honest. They're lying to you. And you need to put a stop to it. You do need to put a stop to it. But I feel like maybe you don't have the strength to put a stop to it. You're repeating the same mistake over at this point with the world reversed and the Wheel of Fortune reversed. There could be something coming back to haunt you, okay? There could be, you know, a shocking, unpredictable loss with the Wheel of Fortune reversed, a setback. Something could be happening, and it's destiny. Okay, we got destiny here. Okay, this is the universe is in control here. You're not in control. You may think that you're in control, but the universe is in control, or this rat is in control. Somebody has complete control over you, whether it's the universe or this rat. This is a fall from grace. Negative, repetitive patterns that are bringing you nowhere. Somebody needs an attitude adjustment. The Hermit. Oh my God. We have so many majors here. This is universe. There's going to be a universal change here. The universe is about to stop something right in its tracks. Maybe they're gonna stop this rat. Maybe the universe is gonna help you because you just can't see. This is enlightenment. This is realizing, doing a lot of thinking. I believe that you are thinking a lot. You're thinking about your past mistakes, right? You are. I think you're going through a period of enlightenment right now. If you're not, you need to. You need to completely go within. You need to withdraw. You need to withdraw. You need some alone time. And you need to listen to yourself. Listen to yourself. Don't listen to this rat. What is your gut telling you to do? Is your gut telling you to push your family aside for this rat? Or is this rat telling you that what you should do? Rats are dirty. Anyway, this is a new perspective. It really is. The Hermit goes within and realizes that their true identity. This is a Jesus consciousness. Taking time to think about what you are not learning. You need to think, you really need to take some time out. You need to take a time out and think about what's going on here. Who's lying to you? Who's being false? I can see that you're in some sort of major, and this is major with all these major cards. This is a major depression. It's a major sad situation. And I think it's because you're not following your heart. You're not acting as your true self. You're not. You're letting this rat take over. So anyway, this is a setback. This is a horrendous loss. And I think that you're feeling the pain of it. It's extremely disheartening. You're feeling it internally. You may be experiencing some health problems. You know, you're feeling very scattered. You may be feeling angry. You may be feeling very emotional. You might not be able to master your emotions very well. I do feel like there's an emotional outburst ahead. I do. King of Pentacles. Now, the King of Pentacles is very practical. This is about money. It does. The King of Pentacles is about money. About stability. Thinking about who you want to give your money to, or thinking about who you want to give stability to, or who you want to share your money with, or that's what you need to think about. I think that you have a lot to offer, and you really need to listen to yourself, not whoever this person is. The Wheel of Fortune reversed and the World card reversed. There's a lack of success. We have somebody here that is, and I think it's you, unfortunately, that is unwilling to take any new approaches. You're stuck in the present. You're resisting change. You're resisting letting go. There's a cycle that needs to end, and it's like you're trying. You're not letting a cycle end. Okay, you haven't learned your lesson yet. I mean, the World card reversed, the lesson hasn't been learned. And it is about money. It's about money. It's about stability. Something is going to come back and haunt you. This is going to come back to haunt you. You really need to think about who you are giving yourself to, who you are giving your money to. That's what you need to think about. This is coming back to haunt you. You are feeling a lot of disruption on the inside from this person that you are dealing with. Maybe you need to take a little vacation by yourself, not with the rat. We do have a big loss here with the Tower reversed and the Wheel of Fortune reversed. This is bad luck, bad timing. Needing time to think. Think about what's practical. About your responsibilities. Queen of Swords reverse. You're dealing with a bitch. This is a nasty individual. Lies like a rug. Likes to keep you confused. This person is harsh, very aggressive, hard to deal with, hard to love. Will say anything to get their own way. King of Cups reversed. This person doesn't have good intentions. It's not about love. It's about financial security. You're dealing with an individual that doesn't have good intentions. This person is a victim. They're very secretive and they're hiding something from you. So I feel like at the end of the month, I feel like you are going, I think it's going to be very emotional. I do. I think there's going to be some upheaval. I think there's going to be some chaos. I feel like something is going to be shown to you that makes you realize, I hope, that you are dealing with a rat. that you are dealing with somebody that only cares about themselves, you will regret it. The Five of Cups reverse is extreme regrets. Strength reversed. Now, this is lack of bravery. We have a coward here. I think that you're dealing with a person that thinks that you are naive. This person thinks that you are weak and vulnerable. They have caused your depression. They lack respect from others, and they love the control that they have over you. I think that you need to find your strength. You need to be brave, and you need to act with integrity and do what's right for you and you only. I think you know what you need to do. But standing up to this rat that is in your household, I think this is in your house. And it doesn't have to be, but I don't know why I feel so strongly about that. If you are single, then it is somebody that you deal with on a regular basis. Or somebody that is lurking. You may be dealing with a couple of rats, because rats multiply. They usually aren't alone. Anyway, I think that you know who you should go with. I think that you know what direction that you should go. But I think there's a lack of courage. There is. There's a lack of strength here. But the Chariot reversed and the Strength card reversed. And maybe you're starting to get sick. Maybe you're getting ill. You're getting sicker. Because stress kills. There is definitely some illness here. You know, maybe your organs or something internally, you know, something is happening. Anyhow, you are dealing with an individual that sees themselves as a victim, and they use emotional blackmail to make you feel guilty, okay? To make you feel guilty. I think it is time for you to put a stop to this person's lies. I think that you need to stand up for yourself, and you need to do the right thing. The end of the month, you're going to be experiencing some sort of chaos. And it has to do with the home, or the family, or the establishment. And I do feel like your emotions are all over the place. Because somebody is lying to you, and you're not seeing it, you know, and it's making you feel uncomfortable. Because deep down inside, I feel like you know. You are dealing, I think for a lot of you, it's a Pisces or a Cancer. This is a very deceptive situation. This is deception. All is not as it seems. Proceed with caution and please follow your gut. You are dealing with a liar. And there is a difficult path ahead if you do not put a squash to it right now. All is not as it seems, Aries. Look deeper. Look deeper. What does your gut say? There will be consequences for going down this path. you're dealing with a very malicious individual. This person is very melodramatic, controlling, revengeful, and self-righteous. They have made you feel inadequate. They have lowered your self-esteem. And I think that you need to take your power back. You need to take control back. Anyway, what is I'm going to get it from the cards. What does Aries need to do? What does Aries need to do at the end of this month, or what is going to happen at the end of this month? Nine of Cups reversed. Now this is very dissatisfied, unhappy. King of Wands, take action. Take action. Do the noble thing. The King of Wands is very protective. Do what makes you happy. Don't let this rat steal your happiness. I feel as though there is something that is going to happen, and it may be, and I'm not sure what it is, but there's going to be a goodbye. Okay, there's going to be a goodbye. This is an ending. This is a mental, physical collapse, a breakdown. This is the death of a situation, giving up. This is sickness. It's illness. It's falling down. It's collapsing. Being stabbed in the back. I think that you are going to realize. I do. I think that you are going to realize that you are stabbed in the back by a rat by the end of the month. There, I mean, the Ten of Swords can be a death. It's an ending. Six of Pentacles reversed. It's abuse of power, abuse of generosity. Realizing that you are dealing with a fraud, that you are dealing with a con. This is an injustice. Realizing that you've been taken advantage of. You've been under somebody's strong control. Not going to give to this person anymore. This is a lack of, this is not giving. And this is somebody not getting what they thought they were going to get. We have a very egotistical individual that just wanted all of it. They wanted all of it. This egotistical individual is not going to get what they thought that they were going to get. So perhaps you are going to take action to do the noble thing, to do the right thing, to do the practical thing. Maybe you're going to realize that you are being taken advantage of by this rat. I feel as though you have been stuck in your head. You've been playing it safe. And it's time to step outside of your safety zone. My advice is to go within. And I think that's what you're going to do right around the corner. You are about to go within. And think about who you are. You're about to realize who you are. Aries, there's going to be an abrupt ending for you. And I think that you're going to see that you are dealing with a very wicked, wicked, wicked individual. And it's going to be very disheartening to see. Be prepared. Get prepared. Get prepared to see who you're dealing with. Good luck.